while you have the wonderful figures of African American history like Martin Luther King and Rosa Parks, there were so many other people who also contributed, but who were just, maybe they had a private sit-in on a bus in their neighborhood, and maybe it didn't make the news, but it made a difference in their neighborhood.
We need to know what happened, why it happened, when it happened, and how is it, learn about the legacies of the people from the past.
But I just didn't see the importance of history because I had boyfriends. That wasn't my life. But then later on, my mother showed me the right trip, the right script, and the right meaning of Black history. And that if you don't show it now, people will forget. So you have to talk about it.
Young people especially who are coming along now to know, you know, how, you know, people lived and the things that they accomplished with having a little of nothing.
Started out really with our church on Alfred Street, Baptist Church in Alexandria on Alfred Street, many years ago. They wanted to get rid of the church and in its place put 20 parking spaces. Well, my mother and several people, I got 9 people around from Alexandria, decided to fight the battle. And they won through the mayor, former mayor. And we ended up allowing them to keep the church and build another church. And they took this library, made it larger, and then it became a museum.
The room that I'm sitting in now, the gallery that I'm in, was actually the library in the 1940s for Black citizens during segregation. And we believe that this library was built in 1940 as a result of a sit-in that took place in August 1939 at the Barrett Library on Queen Street, then known as the Alexandria Library. And we do believe that this is actually the first civil rights action, first act of civil disobedience for African-American civil rights in America.
And they've gone all over Alexandria and found out different pieces that were used by Blacks who had worked in different homes. And as a result, these are some of the things that they decided to, you know, after history and after reading, you can determine what these basically were about.
Young people, they don't feel that interest, I don't think. They need to be more pushed. They need to be encouraged. They have these ideas that is instilled in them, whatever they might be. But when they come here, they develop their own understanding. They develop their own ideas. They see the why, the how come, and they begin to ask questions, which is what we need them to do. They need to start asking questions, and they need to come and see and get the answers for themselves.
Grassroots is an interesting exhibit. It talks about the ancient art of African basket making. It's an art that we want to see being preserved, and I'm just incredibly moved by it because it shows the power of not only American ingenuity that was brought out of the terrible aftermath of the slave trade, how a craft that was made for a truly utilitarian use, cultivating rice, cultivating other crops, has been adapted, and once the slaves were freed, they could make beautiful designs and beautiful baskets that were something that pleased themselves, that was not something that was made necessarily because the slave master wanted it to be made. This now is their art, and it's for them.
It's amazing what these people did with nothing. You know, they had nothing to start with, and what they were able to accomplish. You can't put a price on something like this. You can't put a price on it.